Right, I'm back. Now I need to remember where I was. I think I'd just done this 20k. Had I? Done them both. Pin 8 to ground. And pin 9 to ground. That one. Right, so I guess I want to do the connect the two current control inputs. That's 1 and 16, the two top ones. I don't have to do it like that, I just do it like that. Just go across there. Ooh. No, I can't because I'm hitting that ground. My pliers just to bend the ends so that it meets, so it's easy to bridge across a bit of solder. Go, so they're connected together. So that's this. So all that's left now is the feedback, the input, and the out, and the CV control / CV input. Oh, did I do this? Oh, and I got this wrong, didn't I? That was it. I'm going to have to do a fix. Also, it's 11 connected to 9 volts. Yeah, it is. 8. Yeah, that's done. So, I've got to take these out now. What if I can just disconnect them? I might have to use some wick. Got some goot wick. Temperature a bit higher. That one disconnected. The other one I think is here. Might be able to just pull that one out. Just get the screwdriver in there. Okay. This actually needs to go here. It's a minus 12, so I'll just twist it round. Push it in that hole. Okay, so now I move that one up. I need to get this one. This one's separated. I need to get it from there to up here. So I'll probably just use blue wire. You need it. Where's my wire strippers? These just make it so much simpler. The pad next to it's filled with solder, but put it down roughly. Okay, bit rough, but never mind. So now they're both to minus 12. Now we need to implement these negative feedbacks. So I need another 20k. Just double check that on my bench. This needs to go between 8 and 4. That's on the same side. Lucky. Oh, now I've got this annoying wire. 8 there. 4 is where we've got 1k to ground yet. A bit annoyingly, it's straddling sideways. Oh, what's this one? Oh, it's a pot. I haven't put it in yet. 8, 4 is here. Just that one, that's the one that goes between 8 and 4. Now I need 47k. That's got a part here. That needs to go between 8. No. That needs to go between 9 and 4. Ah. So I'm down in this quite cramped area. Not really any space for it left. Unless I go here. Might just go below. Might have to hack this one on below. Not ideal, but it's a prototype. That's 9. Four must be. Doing any decoupling on this yet. It's probably good practice. Nine to 4, 7k. This negative feedback there. Now we need to connect 8. To one side of 100k. Which one am I going to do if 8? So this one's closest to 8. Look at this one. Just connect it at the bottom. So it's this pin here. That's 9. That's 9. I'm on the wrong side. This pin. I don't know if I'm going to get the rotation right. Don't really care. This is the hot signal. Oh, beautiful, and that's the negative, and it just goes to Earth. So I've just done that. Now all I need is 20k. I'll have to check it on the multimeter again, because it looks so weird. And it's going to the positive, which is pin 3. Great. Goes there. That one's beautiful. Hopefully you won't have to troubleshoot this too much, because it would make this video even more boring. can just go. So now that's going from the tip of the pot to pin 3. That's this one. That's the main circuit all done. Now all we want to do is put in, I'll just do it 100k, but it might be, I'm going to do 100k because I can change the volume of my. I need to remember which one is tip. Best way to find that out is, I can't ever remember which one is tip. So I'll just put a jack in. A multimeter, the one that beeps. So tip. Although it's switched right now. No, it's not. It's not switched. So that. Couldn't remember that. The one opposite, the ones at the bottom here are the tips. So we want to put 100k from there to pin 3. So we could either stick it, it's at the wrong side, so the best option really is just to do it underneath. But that's not solder. So, solder it underneath here. Although that's all going to touch there. So it'll be better to solder it about here. And again, that's not solder. That way the wire won't touch, and we need to get to pin 3, which is this one, right? No, it's this side. Oh no, it's over here. You know what, the best option that should be. Probably to take it out from pin 3. Oh, but I've run out of space. Well, I can put it here, can't I? It's been pin 3, and we want it to go wait, I'm confused. Oh, I was over here, that's why. You just do that. Use a coloured cable. that is the left jack as audio input with 150k. Well, it's 100k. I haven't done a pot for it, I just did straight in. Because of my signal generator, I can just change the amplitude anyway. Now I just do the CV. I probably won't bother doing the resistors, I'll just have no cutoff range. I just need 100k. That 100k. Comes from one of these. You always need more space than you imagine. Best layouts I've done of this style. I just use humongous prototyping boards, because otherwise you end up like this, where it's just so much mess. So this is CV control, so that will be the second one actually. I'm not quite sure do on the audio outputs. They're not, because they go off to another part of the circuit, they're not really, but I might just put 1k's on them because it's a 20k output resistor, and 1k is standard for Eurorack. Shouldn't divide the volume down too much. So what is it, 9 and 8? Oh no, it's in the worst place. I might have to just do it here. So this would be... ideally when I'm making layouts I prefer everything to be on the top, just because it helps you understand. But quite often eventually you have to make compromises. I'm soldering it so that the resistor sits over that bar wire that's going across here. Thinking about it, it would have been better to put the ground wire at the bottom. Okay. That is that, that, And I've done this sort of, but I haven't limited the range of the pot. So that, in theory, just pulling up the IC. So in theory that should work. I'm sure I might have made mistakes. Do a quick idiot test to see if I haven't got any shorts. I need to wire in. Got this power jack. Supply. Sure there's nothing shorting. Power seems fine. I'll turn off. You can see these lights. Seems to run. Now the test is to put in some audio. Have a simple, is it this one that was audio? Have a simple signal generator here. Should probably make up a cable for that. Actually, I just realised I haven't got the oscilloscope set up. Oh, and I have no way to ground it either. Because it's not a breadboard. What do I want to do? I could just go for it and see if any audio comes through. Do I solder? I can solder. I cut these cables. These are just cheap jumper tape cables. You can get like hundreds of them for not much money. Solder straight to ground there. Actually, think and I might just use the other one as a probe for now with my fingers. I need to see. Can I? Sorry, I haven't got the app open. On keycap, but I'll put it on waveforms. Scope. Shrink it down so it fits. think I might just... Okay. Crocodile clip. See if I can hack it on there so I can just see the waveform first. So the waveform is on now. You can't see it because I have a camera on it, but I run this. Yeah, there you go. I've got a square wave. It's at a kilohertz and the amplitude is quite low. It's half a volt peak to peak, I think. So if I made it a volt peak to peak, then I want, because this is a two channel scope, get the other one. Which one's which? Can I just hack that there? Ooh. What's this? So, interesting. The output is very negative. It might be, yeah. Well, I need to find a screwdriver. This is resonance. Doesn't do anything. This is cut off. Doesn't do anything. Low pass. It's right at the bottom. All right. So we're gonna have to trace the signal. If I push that off, wait. Bit hacked this. Okay. Chip feels good. So our signal, if you look on the schematic, should end up at pin 3. Our scope cannot see anything at pin 3. Why is that? Oh, because it's the current input. It'd be best to look at 8. But at 8, we're right off the bottom. We're at -4. Can't remember which one's cut off. 3 back. So that one's resonance. This one's resonance, I think. This one is cut off. Is that right? This one has nothing on its tip. Wait, I haven't finished. Why is this pot not connected at all? I've connected this one. I can see its tip goes to pin 3, so that's the resonance, but the cutoff is not. That would explain it. I missed the cutoff, I just. Ah, damn it. I'm gonna have to resolder. Well, I'm gonna have to actually put it in. So I need. I need to get a red wire. Sorry, I'm just in a bit of a muddle. Come on, red wire. Excuse me. Probably good if we had a. I think I need a studio camera so you can actually see me jumping around. I'll do it underneath. So this is not connected in the slightest. But I thought I'd connected a resistor to it, a 100k resistor. Oh, I did. Where is it? It needs to be 100k resistor going to that one or that one. Is it there? Yeah. Yeah, and it's connected up to here, but it's not connected to anything. So what I probably want. I don't really know which way would be open or closed on the filter. But I'll do red here. And red just needs to go to. Here. That's just straight to red on the. Oh, that's straight to 12 volts on the prototype supply. I've lost my blue wire. Where's my blue wire? That should be negative 12, which will be too extreme. I hope I don't put too much current into the. There's probably a limit. I'll double check. And then the center. Oh dear, that's connected there. Oh, Oh, you I connected it. Yeah. See, the problem is my mind went funny and I did 100k up to a connector, but it actually makes more sense for the time being anyway to not have the cutoff. I won't test that today. I'll have it going straight to the pot. Okay. Let me just double check the data sheet. Diode bias current, amplifier bias current, maximum 2 milliamps. But it's going through 100k resistor. So what is that? I've got a calculator. Could be 12 milliamps. Is it plus minus? No, this is two. Does that mean? Must be 12. So the maximum current will be under a milliamp. It's fine. Just had to double check that. So that's the signal in again. Power, connect the scope, oh yeah, I can see the signal again, well I can still see the signal, now if I run it what happens, not eating any more current, oops. Now what happens if I probe 8? Something there. It's not shot off into rail. Oh. Seems like something. Is that resonance? Maybe. It's very quiet. It's very resonant. Yeah, I can see that's just squealing. Maybe something's wrong with the resonance. It'd be good to hear it. What could I do about hearing it? I have these speakers. Another thing I haven't planned. USB, the USB powered speakers. They've got no volume control on them. So this might be a bit painful. I'll stick it to power them. Oh, interesting. Seems like I've got a lot of resonance. Maybe the resonance isn't set up properly. Ah. Might just be because I was... Ah, there you go. Maybe if I put the current control out of range, it goes funny. Because my... Now, where's a proper screwdriver? Might be nice to use a lower frequency. Okay, that doesn't seem right. Oh, cutoff is on the right. Wait, what? Oh, it is on the right. Yeah, of course it's on the right. So this is resonance. Low pass. Just hear it with that resonance. Put higher amplitude wave in it. To see it as well. I have to stick it. It's lost a bit of gain. See how it... The blue one is the... Interesting thing is it drops like that. Oh. What have I done? I knocked the input. The resonance. Get it. If you're really, I need finer control over the resonance, but. If you get it to a very fine level, it makes this amazing sound. That's the low pass. This is the band pass. All resonance. It has a funny click because it disappears down to minus. Okay. And that's a good place to stop. That's what it's like. Although I really would like to show the amazing oscillation. There's not enough turn in the pot. If you get it just on the edge of oscillation, oh, that's horrible. Resistor in. More on this later. Anyway, that's enough for this one. Bye. Bye.